Yasser's one of those kind of guys, and he's our second last speaker for the day, if I'm not wrong. Yasser, please, everyone, welcome him!
السلام عليكم. أنا اليوم هقدم لكم على السريع كده نعرف آخر اليوم ما أبغى أتقل عليكم very quickly هتكلم عن إنجازات السعودية في الرياضات الإلكترونية و electronic sports. Just quick thing on. I'm also a TED translator. I'm the first who ever translated TED into Arabic. Alhamdulillah. I was the most translator or the most active translator for 14 weeks for TED. And then, alhamdulillah, I handed over the flag to another Arab brother, Anwar, who's Sudanese. So far, I translated 47. He translated, so far, 470. So, not a big difference. Okay. So, what is esports? Basically, esports is a very fancy word we like to use to describe competing on computer games. That's basically it. So, of course, esports does not necessarily mean that we play sport games. So, you can have car racing, you can have football, you can have shooting, you can have strategy, whatever. We have very long, not very long, but we have a very strong history in esports in Saudi. Esports has really launched globally around 2000, in the year 2000, with WCG, the first really global event. However, Saudi started participating in global events in 2004, which was the second year for the World Cup. And alhamdulillah, one of our players, Ala Hakim, kisib laqab khamis al-alam. We made it to the quarterfinals. So, to make it to the quarterfinals from our first try in a World Cup in a highly technical and technology-oriented category for Saudi was amazing for us. It was an amazing experience. But what was really even better was his brother winning the world champion title in 2005. So these are our players for the first 2 years, 2005, 2004, 2005. This is our proud cup. Alhamdulillah, 2006, we had a defending champion going into the World Cup. بس للأسف جاتوا مباراة ضد لاعب إسرائيلي في أول بطولة وكانت إسرائيل دوبها داخلة الليلة اللي قبلها على جنوب لبنان. Media was all focused on the Israeli Arab issue and media in the World Cup was focused on him because he's the world champion. So you can imagine when these two topics clash, okay, you really need to think of what you're gonna do next. At the end of the day, it was his decision. He consulted with all of us, but at the end of the day, he decided that he was not going to play the Israeli player. And because of that, the World Cup committee said, if you don't play, you are disqualified. Okay? He was in group stage, he could have made it to the end of the tournament, but they told him, just sit down next to him, don't play, okay, lose the match, you're still going to qualify. But if you don't play, and refuse to play and try to make a political issue out of it, they're going to disqualify him. He said, by forcing me to play, you are taking a political position. So he refused to play, he lost the title. You can imagine a student, university student, he owns nothing in the world except this title. The fact that he let go of it just for the cause. Regardless if you agree or disagree if that was the right action, it's a huge sacrifice, and I'm sure not a lot of us can claim that we sacrificed everything we actually hold dear because of the cause. Of course, Palestinians sacrifice much more. Allah ya'inahum kullahum. But from outsiders, I don't think anybody else can claim that he did something like that. So alhamdulillah, although we're in computer gaming, which people think is a very minor thing and not important, we're still able to do something. 20,000 articles online were talking about why would a world champion dump his title to refuse to sit down next to Israeli amongst young people who never talk about the cause. 2007, we had another great player, Mohammed Bakhallak. He won fourth place. And for the first time, we had a Saudi referee, which is Nawaf Abul Khel. 2008, we did the first ever global professional, or the first ever professional electronic football league in the world. And we did it in Saudi Arabia, designed by us, and the whole world loved the concept that we created. We had huge coverage that we established in 2000, sorry, in 2000, and we started in 2009, in 2008, 2009, the Electronic Sports International Federation with seven member countries was founded in Los Angeles. And I was voted unanimously as the first president for that federation. 2009, there wasn't any global events, but we had the Saudi player, Adnan Al-Malki, won the Middle East champion title. 2010, we had Mansour Al-Awadi won fifth place in the World Cup, and Mohammed Al-Jabri won Middle East champion again. So, as you can see, for 6 years, Saudi Arabia has always been ranked in the top eight countries of the world in this game, which is, alhamdulillah, a huge achievement, especially if you know that we are participating on all our own expense, and sometimes we have sponsors that pay for the tickets. The professional now, to take it to the next level with the Electronic Sports Federation, we created six professional teams in Saudi Arabia that are participating in the professional league. I know most of you are laughing at the last name, so. That was their choice because they have KFUPM and they all think of themselves as nerds, and proud nerds they are. Okay, thank you very much. And just quick background, this is the most important thing. If you see, the top eight countries of the world are France, Germany, Spain, Portugal, Brazil, China, and Saudi. You can see in football, all of the top countries are there, and somehow Saudi made it next to them. So, thank you very much.
Good evening, assalamu alaikum, welcome again. It's been a long evening. I strongly support you guys. There's been a lot of exciting speeches and a lot of energy. All of you have been here, been really nice and supportive. Now it's time for our last speaker, our speaker for the evening, our star of the day. Can everyone please put your hand together for Dr. Naif AlMutlaq. Okay.
This is an old machine. Oh, so what?